Coming up on 5 Minute News. Banker kills four colleagues in Louisville, Kentucky. Tennessee lawmaker reinstated after expulsion over gun protest. And leaked documents may have origin in chatroom for gamers. It's Tuesday, April 11. I'm Anthony Davis. A 23-year-old bank employee armed with a rifle shot dead four colleagues and wounded nine other people at his workplace on Monday while live-streaming the attack in downtown Louisville, Kentucky. The attacker was fatally shot at the scene, the Louisville Metro Police Department said, but it was unclear whether he died from police gunfire or a self-inflicted wound. Police identified the shooter as Connor Sturgeon, who joined the downtown branch of the Old National Bank as a full-time employee last year. In the latest in a long series of mass shootings in the U.S., police said they responded within minutes to reports of an attacker at about 8:30 a.m. at the bank office near Slugger Field Baseball Stadium. Police identified the dead as 40-year-old Joshua Barrick, 63-year-old Thomas Elliott, 45-year-old Juliana Farmer, and 64-year-old James Tutt. Kentucky Governor Andy Beshear, on the verge of tears, said during a news briefing that he knew some of the victims, including Elliott, a senior vice president at the bank. "He taught me how to help build my law career. He helped me become governor. He gave me advice on being a good dad," Beshear said, "one of the people I talked to most in the world." Two police officers were among the nine people wounded, including a 26-year-old recent police academy graduate who was struck in the head and remained in critical condition after brain surgery on Monday. Mass shootings have become commonplace in the United States. So far in 2023, the nation has experienced 146 mass shootings, the most at this point in the year since 2016. Despite daily atrocities, Republican lawmakers show little appetite for gun safety laws. Tennessee State Representative Justin Jones returned to the State House on Monday, pumping his fist and declaring power to the people as a Nashville area council restored him to office following his expulsion over a gun protest. Republican lawmakers ousted Jones and another young black legislator last week over their gun control protest on the House floor, capturing national attention with Democrats seeking to advance gun violence prevention and racial equality, while Republicans wielded their supermajority power. County legislators are empowered to fill local vacancies to the Tennessee State House until a special election can be held to fill out the remainder of the two-year term. The Metropolitan Council of Nashville and Davidson County voted 36-0 on Monday to make 27-year-old Jones the interim representative. He had been elected to Tennessee's House of Representatives last year. Republicans on Thursday voted to kick Jones out and fellow Democrat Justin Pearson, but spared a white representative who joined them in their rule-breaking demonstration in the well of the House floor on March 30th. Pearson could get a similar vote for reinstatement on Wednesday when the Shelby County Board of Commissioners will consider reappointing him to his Memphis district. The three were protesting the legislature's stance on guns in the wake of the March 27 shooting at a Nashville school that killed 3 9-year-old students and 3 staff members. The Metro Council vote set off a celebration among some 600 protesters gathered outside, as people greeted Jones with cheers of welcome home. A major leak of classified U.S. documents that shaken Washington and exposed new details of its intelligence gathering may have started in a chat room on a social media platform popular with gamers. Held on the Discord platform, which hosts real-time voice, video, and text chats, a discussion originally created to talk about a range of topics turned to the war in Ukraine. As part of debates about Ukraine, according to one member of the chat, an unidentified poster shared documents that were allegedly classified, first typing them out with the poster's own thoughts, then, as of a few months ago, beginning to post images of papers with folds in them. The posts appear to have gone unnoticed outside of the chat until a few weeks ago, when they began to circulate more widely on social media and got picked up by major news outlets. The leaks have alarmed US officials and sparked a Justice Department investigation. The records have provided startling and surprisingly timely details of US and NATO assistance to Ukraine. They also provided clues about efforts to assist Ukraine in its war with Russia, including an anticipated spring offensive. The scale of the exposure has yet to be determined. Also unclear is whether any government worked to share the documents or manipulate them. Asked on Monday if the US government was effectively waiting for more intelligence documents to show up online, National Security Council spokesman John Kirby replied, "The truth and honest answer to your question is, we don't know. And is that a matter of concern to us? You're darn right it is." The Associated Press news agency reviewed images of documents that appeared in recent weeks in the discussion forums. They include a top-secret analysis of deepening intelligence service ties between Russia's FSB and agencies in the United Arab Emirates, the oil-rich Persian Gulf nation that hosts a US airbase and cooperates on many security matters with Washington. You can subscribe to the 5-Minute News Patreon for bonus videos, commentary, and more. Go to patreon.com/5MinuteNews.